सुनिए सद्गुरु डिस्कोर्सेस कारवा 2.0 पर।
हाय, दिस इज उत्कर्ष, उत्कर्ष पटेल एंड वेलकम टू अ वर्ल्ड ऑफ सम ब्यूटीफुल स्टोरीज, स्टोरीज फ्रॉम मिथोलॉजी, लेजेंड्स, फोक टेल्स एंड एपिक्स। व्हाइल वी हैव लिसन्ड टू मेनी स्टोरीज फ्रॉम रामायण, डिफरेंट वर्जन्स ऑफ रामायण, टुडे लेट मी टेल यू अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फोक टेल व्हिच एनलिस्ट्स द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ लिसनिंग टू द एपिक रामायण। In earlier days, there were recitals of the epic over days, and this story, or rather this folktale, is based on one such event that takes place in a village. The story is from the collection of folktales by A.K. Ramanujan, the folklorist of India. A villager who had no sense of culture and no interest in it either was married to a woman who was very cultured. She tried various ways to cultivate his taste for the higher things in life, but he just wasn't interested. One day a great narrator, kathakar as they are often called, of that grand epic of Ramayana came to the village. Every evening he would sing, recite and explain the verses of the epic. The whole village went to this one-man performance as if it were a rare feast. The woman who was married to the uncultured dolt tried to interest him in the performance. She nagged him and nagged him, trying to force him to go and listen. This time he grumbled as usual but decided to satisfy her. So he went in the evening and sat at the back. It was an all-night performance and he just couldn't keep awake. He slept through the night. Early in the morning, when a canto had been ended and the narrator sang the closing verses of the day, sweets were distributed according to the custom. Someone put some sweet in his mouth of the sleeping man. He woke up soon after and went home. His wife was delighted that her husband had stayed through the night and asked him eagerly how he enjoyed the Ramayana. He said it was very sweet. The wife was happy to hear it. The next day too, his wife insisted on his listening to the epic. So he went to the enclosure where the narrator was performing, sat against a wall and before long fell fast asleep. The place was crowded and a young boy sat on his shoulder, made himself comfortable and listened open-mouthed to the fascinating story. In the morning, when the night's portion of the story came to an end, everyone got up and so did the husband. The boy had left earlier, but the man felt aches and pains from the weight he had borne all night. When he went home and his wife asked him eagerly how it was, he said, "It got heavier and heavier by the morning." The wife said, "That's the way the story is." She was happy that her husband was at last beginning to feel the emotions and the greatness of the epic. On the third day, he sat at the edge of the crowd and was so sleepy that he lay down on the floor and even snored. Early in the morning, a dog came that way and urinated into his mouth a little before he woke up and went home. When his wife asked him how it was, he moved his mouth this way and that way and made a face and said, "Terrible, it was so salty." His wife knew something was wrong. She asked him what exactly was happening and didn't let up till he finally told her how he had been sleeping through the performance every night. On the fourth day, his wife went with him, sat him down in the very first row and told him sternly that he should keep awake no matter what happened. So he sat dutifully in the front row and began to listen. Very soon he was caught up in the adventures and the characters of the great epic story. On that day, the narrator was enchanting the audience with a description of how Hanuman, the monkey, had to leap across the ocean to take Rama's signet ring to Sita. When Hanuman was leaping across the ocean, the signet ring slipped from his hand and fell into the ocean. Hanuman didn't know what to do. He had to get the ring back quickly and take it to Sita in the demon's kingdom. While he was wringing his hand, the husband, who was listening with rapt attention in the front row, said, "Hanuman, don't worry, I'll get it for you." Then he jumped up and dived into the ocean, found the ring in the ocean floor, brought it back and gave it to Hanuman. Everyone was astonished. They thought this man was someone special, really blessed by Ram and Hanuman. Ever since, he has been respected in the village as a wise elder, and he was also behaved like one. That's what happens when you really listen to a story, especially if it is Ramayana. If you found this version of why one should listen to Ramayana interesting, come back for more of such stories. Till then, let me listen to my favorite song and you listen to yours on Saregama Karwa.
वाह वाह राम जी जोड़ी क्या बनाई भैया और भाभी को बधाई हो बधाई सब रस्मों से बड़ी है जग में दिल से दिल की सगाई
आपकी कृपा से ये शुभ घड़ी आई जी जी और जीजा को बधाई हो बधाई सब रस्मों से बड़ी है जग में दिल से दिल की सगाई
वाह वाह राम जी
वाह वाह राम जी
वाह वाह राम जी भैया जो चुप बैठे हैं देखो भाभी ये कैसे ऐठे हैं ऐसे बड़े ही भले हैं ऐसे बड़े ही भले हैं माना थोड़े मन चले हैं पर आपके सिवा कहे भी न फिसले हैं
देखो देखो खुद पे जी जी तिराई
भैया और भाभी को बधाई हो बधाई सब रस्मों से बड़ी है जग में दिल से दिल की सगाई वाह वाह राम जी
अरे वाह वाह राम जी
वाह वाह राम जी मैंने मांगी थी वैसी भाभी पाई
जी जी और जीजा को बधाई हो बधाई
सब रस्मों से बड़ी है जग में दिल से दिल की सगाई वाह वाह राम जी
अरे वाह वाह राम जी
वाह वाह राम जी